to bring them here safely in Jesus' name. And at the end of this service, God will allow us to glorify your name. Thank you, most gracious Father, for we pray through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Thank you. precious and
the
Holy Spirit.
Magnify the Lord with me.
Let us all sustain together.
This is the day when the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad at ease.
Through the heavens, through the earth, through our lives. Thank you. the Holy Gospel is written. It's the fifth chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew, beginning at the 13th verse.
Faithful unto you and your ministry in Jesus' take the warnings and the small LOC that has been put together to work. We appreciate you for your support in Nika and in the running of the church. God bless you, everybody, in Jesus' name. Every time the coordinator of our land and provost, the short pastors that have been speaking to us these few minutes, and all who have been assigned one role on earth, let me thank the leadership of the women, my wife, and Grandma Kuros, and all the ladies and wives, for this coming together again to fellowship in the glory of God. I pray that our time here will be of great fellowship in the glory of God in Jesus' name. Amen. For many years, we used to take the privilege of gathering for granted. But this year, COVID-19 altered our lives. And we found out that even in peace time, it may become impossible to gather. I remember the last time personally experienced this kind of lockdown was in the year 1966. We were in the north and the pool happened and there were just killings here and there. The whole place was locked down. The country itself was locked down. Now, hopefully, we all can place better value on the privilege of freedom, on the privilege of togetherness, and give thanks to God accordingly. This is a fellowship time for the family of God in the house of clergy of our diocese. It is our time to pray and learn together as a family. And it is important that we gather like this from time to time, because our Lord Jesus Christ taught us that people ought to pray and not faint. In fact, that story is worth looking at as we welcome all of us to this 2020 Clergywives Conference. In the book of St. Luke, chapter 18, and verse 1 to 8, the Lord told his disciples the story of, or parable of persistence of a particular widow. And in the parable, we read that there was a judge who neither feared God or regarded God. Also, there was a widow who had a need for a redress. The widow resorted to the judge for redress, but the judge paid no attention to her. However, this widow will not get no for an answer. She kept pestering the judge with a plea until her persistence wore down on the judge's unwillingness. Luke 18 verse 4. Though I fear not God, nor regard man, yet, because this widow troubled me, I will avenge her, lest by her continual coming she weary me. In other words, there is benefit in the prayer of opportunity. Those who refuse to give up, but who continue in supplication, they will gain the reward of the opportunity. And listen to what the Lord says in verse 6 to 8, Luke 18. Hear what the unjust judge I will stand upon my watch and set me upon the tower. I will watch to see what he will say unto me. And what I shall answer when I am reproved. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision, make it plain upon tables, that he may wrong that readeth it. For the vision is yet for an appointed time. But at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry. Beloved fathers and mothers, the situation of our nation now calls for opportunity in prayers. As we shepherd the flock of Christ, we must not become discouraged. Yet, it is looking as if the more we pray, the worse things become. But we must make up our mind to rise above discouragement and despondency. Remember the word of the Lord in our mouth is the word of life. And we must not allow the enemy to silence us. I think also 2 Kings chapter 13 and 14 to 19. In that passage, we read the story of the encounter between Elisha, the prophet, and King Joash. Elisha was going to invoke his spiritual authority in aid of the king who had overcome his enemies. He laid his hands on the arrows of the king and asked him to shoot, verse 16 and 17. And he said to the king of Israel, put thy hand upon the bow. And he put his hand upon it. And Elisha put his hand upon the king's hand. And he said, open the window eastward. And he opened it. Then Elisha said, shoot. And he shot. And he said, the arrow of the Lord's deliverance. And the arrow of deliverance from Syria. For thou shalt smite the Syrians in Aphek, till thou hast consumed them. The king had a grand opportunity to leverage on divine assistance and make great progress. But what he did do, he took the minimalistic way of response. He shot the arrow 3 times only and stopped. Even though the prophet gave him a blank check, or even like open check, shoot, he opted to shoot only 3 times. Then he stopped. A lazy man's approach. A man who can easily give up. A woman who cannot remain strong in the place of the Most High. 2 Kings 13, 19. And the man of God was wrong with him. That was the reaction of the man of God. And said, thou shouldest have fighting 5 or 6 times. Then hadest thou smiting Syria, till thou hast consumed it. And whereas now thou shalt smite Syria by thrice. Beloved, what I observe is that Nigeria is being recolonized politically, economically, socially, and in terms of security. We are being recolonized. We have no power again, no resistance. You want to understand what I'm saying? and read what Festus added to their lives, you will know that it's a grave situation. The Chinese are people buying up our lands, and the buyers are selling because they are hungry. In fact, in some situations, they will sell to three buyers. If you buy your land after 2 years, nobody sees you, no fine, it will be sold again. And if you are not careful, you cannot trust the seller. We have been recolonized. The siege from outside is part of the process of recolonization. Because when power and freedom is taken away from you, you begin to be followed. So as we intercede for our nation, Nigeria, at this critical hour of need, and as we bring the needs of our families and of our parishes before the Lord, we need to adopt the attitude of opportunity in prayer. And this conference offers us another opportunity to shoot out our spiritual arrows. Let us avoid the minimalistic approach. Let us shoot as many times as possible. In fact, let us keep shooting spiritual arrows until we hear the ball stop from above. And may that stop be a positive response to our request in the name of Jesus Christ. And as a result of that, I believe we shall have total victory. The Lord is able and willing to help us and to fit us to become winners and champions in spiritual warfare if we yield ourselves to Him. So we need you from here. That can do attitude. That it is possible attitude. We need that attitude from here. Paul introduced to the Philippians when he said, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. That should be our mindset to the people of God. As we learn and pray these few days. So as we gather at the feet of the Lord in this mountain, I plead that we yield ourselves to Him for a transforming experience. You will remember, when Saul met Paul, when Saul met Samuel, the national prophet, give him instruction, which if he obeyed, would make him a different person. You will remember. In fact, Samuel said that at the end of obeying all the instructions, this is what will happen to Saul. It's recorded in 1 Samuel chapter 10 verse 6. And the Spirit of the Lord will come upon thee, and thou shalt prophesy with them, and shalt be turned into another man. Amen. And thou shalt come into another man. When you come in contact with the divine, you become another man. You become another woman. And the question is, since we came in contact with the divine, it does not matter how many years ago, have you become another man? Or you are still the same man? Have you become another? be in a system and not be part of the system. We are clearly even in our midst here. And the grace of God, these 3 days, we shall try to unravel some of the things. You can be part of the system and not aligning to the system. But the joy of it is that the gates of hell shall not prevail. I pray that these 3 days, God will come mightily upon all our resource pastors. And David, speak the mind of God to us, and that we all too may receive a transform and give this place to go back into the world. Tell our congregation, our parishioners, yes, come on today. Gates of hell shall not be there. Even individually, if you know it, you believe it, you are in it, and you are part of it, you can declare, no, God says the Lord, the gates of hell shall not be there. Even over my children, my family, the gates of hell cannot be there. We must come to that point of boldness in the Lord to declare. He says in that passage, if you lose anything on earth, it's impossible in heaven. If you find anything on earth, it's gone in heaven. When last did you buy? When last did you lose? It does not end with the ordination declaration. This is power that you have been given. And the power is in you. Have you used it? Do you recognize it? Are you using it? Whatever you found on earth is found in heaven. Whatever you lose on earth is losing in heaven. When last did you use it? When last did you burn? And you keep on complaining that man has been troubling you in the DCC, in the church. No, you can't be complaining. There's power at your beck and call. Use it to build the church of God with glory and honor. Now to the King Eternal, immortal, invisible and wise God, the astral all honor, power, dominion and might, now and forevermore.
We have found our faith in the words
parish and all our love. Give us good plans for miracles, mutual need, for mercy, for favor, for answered prayers. Let us appreciate our God and our Father who never fails. Thank you.
Thank you.
and we must follow his example and obey his command. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, this day is open. And one, the day to cross his body and blood. Will in the same time that it was betrayed, to pray, and gave him thanks. He broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." The same way after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Trust in me.
contemplate the sin before of our Lord Jesus Christ in the table, and his blood which is shed for you, eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of Christ keep you in eternal life.
Mm-hmm.
The blood of Christ keep you in eternal life.
Thank you. be ablution him. Please be upstanding. Bring light to others. We whom the Spirit lights, give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and your children shall be free, and you will have leave to praise your name through Christ our Lord.
Guru